Last week on WCW Saturday Night, Barry Windham violently attacked his former tag team partner, Dustin Rhodes. And tonight, the two tall Texans go one-on-one. Two of WCW's newest teams collide when Z-Man and Johnny Gunn answer the challenge of Tex Slasinger and Shanghai Pierce. And the unified world tag team champions, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Shane Douglas, battle stunning Steve Austin and beautiful Bobby Eaton with Michael Hayes ringside. All this and more. Next on WCW Saturday Night.
Broadcast for you, and Larry, we're just a couple of weeks away from Starrcade 92 right here at Atlanta's Omni.
You know, the intensity amongst the wrestlers is growing. The boys are training harder than ever, getting ready for Starrcade 92. I hear it through the grapevine, and I see with my own eyes, Jim, they're getting ready.
One of the most intense struggles at Starrcade 92 will be for the King of Cable Championship. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring out here to center stage and our national television audience, the man from Venice Beach, California. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Sting! The Stinger making his way here, ladies and gentlemen, not only will defend his Battle Bowl championship on Monday, December 28th, but Stinger also in the finals for the King of Cable with Big Van Vader.
That's right, Rossi. It's double time for me on one of the biggest wrestling events a world championship wrestling has to show for, and that's Starrcade in the Omni. First, it's Battle Bowl, the lethal lottery. I get to draw a name, and whatever name I draw, that is going to be my partner, and we got to work together as a team if we want to make it to Battle Bowl. And last but not least, double time it is. It's going to be King of Cable, you, Van Vader. I haven't forgotten about the pain that you inflicted on me, and I haven't forgotten about the pain you've inflicted on so many others. You've ruined a lot of wrestling careers, my friend. It's double time for me, and if you haven't figured it out by now, Vader, I'm at my best when I'm on overtime. Figure it out.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Stinger obviously ready for December the 28th in the Omni, Starrcade 92. We're ready for a great broadcast. Let's go up to Tony Gillen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first match on WCW Saturday Night is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Team number one weighs at a combined weight of 609 pounds and hailing from Amarillo, Texas, Tex Slasinger and Shanghai Pierce.
Got a surprise for you boys right now. Take a look.
The two big men from the Lone Star State of Texas with that hook 'em horn sign as they made their way to the ring. We still don't know what was in that bag last week, and they got the bag with them here again this week.
Yeah, all we know is it's got something to do with Z-Man and Johnny Gunn being real pretty.
Ladies and gentlemen, our opponents weigh at a combined weight of 490 pounds, the Z-Man and Johnny Gunn!
We saw this situation really get started a couple of weeks ago, and right now, they're not waiting for any formalities to be exchanged. Z-Man and Gunn came to fight, and fight is what they're doing right here. Slasinger and Pierce have got to get back to the North 40 here and regroup.
Well, they better regroup. They weren't expecting this attack. I tell you, neither was I.
Another offensive flurry. Again, Z-Man and Johnny Gunn are ruling the ring here.
Well, they mean business, and that's the attitude you have to have, Jim. You know, Tex Slasinger, Shanghai Pierce, they're not going to cut you a break in there, so you can't blame the Z-Man and Gunn for doing what they're doing. I still want to see what's in that bag.
Referee Nick Patrick trying to calm down this very emotional young duo of Z-Man and Gunn, and it will be the Z-Man now that things are finally getting somewhat normal, squaring off with the Shanghai Pierce. It's a side headlock.
Yeah. You know, I tell you, that was real good psychology on the part of Z-Man and Gunn. Now that I think about it, they did to Shanghai and Slazenger what I think, you know, they were planning to do to these two guys. Be aggressive and catch them off guard.
Tremendous shoulder lock by the Z-Man. Going left to right here. Nice agility by Shanghai Pierce. But
oh!
Z-Man saw that one coming, dropped the foot right in the face, and there's the exchange.
Well, I tell you, Shanghai Pierce and Slazenger, they're not going to compete with Z-Man and Gunn if they're going to rely on speed. Look at the speed of the Z-Man.
This is like a secondary trying to cover Andre Rison and Michael Pritchard. You can't do it with one guy. These guys have got so much speed. The Z-Man and Gunn, and they're utilizing that particular asset to their its maximum effectiveness.
Yeah, well, that's what they're going to have to do. Tag in, tag out, be fast. Don't make any mistakes.
Gunn with the armbar on the Big Tech Slazenger. And they have come with a lot of sudden offense, and we're seeing more of it here. And Slazenger somewhat disoriented as half in and half out of the ring.
Yeah, probably frustrated too. I mean, it's frustrating when, you know, you're trying to tie up with somebody and they're throwing you all over the place. I think Slazenger and Shanghai, they're gonna have to change their strategy here and really get these guys on the mat.
Tag was made, Z-Man back in there, makes another quick exchange with Johnny Gunn. Quick tags in and out, keeping Schlesinger somewhat off balance here, as Schlesinger and Pierce have yet to really gain any offensive momentum whatsoever, Larry.
No, I think he's trying to figure out what to do. These guys are attacking the wrist. They're attacking his arm right there. Boom, now they're on his shoulder. I think they caught these two guys off guard at the beginning of the match, and they still haven't regrouped yet.
Schlesinger had to go down or get his elbow ripped there. That was the pressure point.
Look at the leverage Johnny Gunn's got on his shoulder here. Actually, he'd be better off if he straightened out Schlesinger's arm. He'd get even more leverage. See, he's got his arm too close to his chest. If he was to pry Schlesinger's arm out, there's the bag. At least it wasn't moving.
Question is, what's in the bag? And there is the tag. Again, the focus of Z-Man and Gunn. The arm of Schlesinger here at this particular juncture of the contest. Hammerlock, another quick tag. They are keeping Schlesinger in their half of the ring almost exclusively.
Yeah, they're showing excellent teamwork here. But I think one of the major factors is they got to keep these guys on the mat. You know, focusing on the arm is one thing, but while Schlesinger is on his feet like this, he's still a big, tough, dangerous man.
Irish whip is reversed there, and nobody home. Schlesinger able to move out of the way and avoid the shoulder block from Johnny Gunn.
Oh.
And he pulls a page out of their playbook with that armbar takedown.
And now he's got the hammer lock back on Gunn. Now he's in the right corner.
Gunn in danger of having his shoulder dislocated here. And big Shanghai Pierce coming right off the second turnbuckle, stomping on the arm and shoulder.
Now see, Schlesinger had his body over the man's shoulder, so he had a good leverage advantage on there.
Excellent teamwork by Schlesinger and Pierce. Continuing to keep the pressure on the arm of Johnny Gunn via the hammer lock. They have him back in their corner, exactly where they want him. And there you see Shanghai gaining an unfair advantage here. Z-Man sees it, but the referee did not.
So it counts. You know, you're not going to see nothing super fancy from these men, but it's going to be very effective.
Big double handful of hair. It takes the young man from Philadelphia right to the turnbuckle. Gunn trying to fight out of the corner, but to no avail here.
Yeah, he's trying to fight, but I don't think he's got any wind left. These guys have been very effective on this. Again, working on the neck, cutting off the wind. I can't tell if that's a choke hold from here or not, but it looks pretty close. Referee's in the wrong position to see it. Two Patricks on the other side.
Z-Man trying to get the tag. There they make the tag, but I don't think it's going to count.
No, it's a good deceptive mover by Slazenger. He's got a rope.
They've got that bull rope, and they hung him with it. What a clothesline. Johnny Gunn out here on the floor now.
You know, I think after he got that right across the throat, he fell, hit his shoulder on his cement.
Referee's going to call for disqualification.
What?
That bell's not legal, Larry. They can't use that or have it in the ring.
Well, they got it now. I didn't think the referee saw it. Oh. That's one way to break a neck. It's a dress.
Oh, yeah. They got a dress in that bag. They're going to try to... Oh, what a humiliating experience.
That's what they mean. They're so pretty, the guy should be in a dress.
They're trying to put that dress on the Z-Man. Johnny Gunn back in. Gunn hammering away. Slashinger and Pierce have done their damage. They've done their damage, but they lose it via disqualification.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the Z-Man and Johnny Gunn via disqualification.
Fans, Tony Schiavone will talk to Barry Windham next on TBS.
Fans, welcome back to WCW Saturday Night. And still to come, our big main event, one-on-one, Dustin Rhodes against Barry Windham. I'm going to be talking to Barry right here in the dressing room area. But before I do, last week, Dustin one-on-one against Stunning Steve Austin, and then Barry Windham attacks.
You know, it doesn't look to me like Rhodes got Austin locked good. I don't think he can do it with that wrist. Look at the way his one forearm's flopping over. He's not locking those fingers together. Look at him shaking those fingers. His hands hurt.
Snapmare, good counter. Rhodes able to keep Austin away from him. Again, a snapmare this time by Rhodes. Again, back into that reverse chin lock. And it's almost as if Rhodes is just almost wrestling a defensive style match because of his injury.
That's very good. In fact, that's exactly what he's doing. He's hitting Austin with some combinations, and he has to do that because he can't hold the man down. And I think he's going to have a hard time cradling him up, trying to pin him. You need two hands to wrestle. Oh.
Man, Austin goes right back on that wrist, and it takes it to the turnbuckle, slams it there.
Austin's got the right game plan.
Well, that's a very light cast, and it has been approved by WCW officials.
If it was approved by officials to be in the ring, that means it's not hard.
It's pliable.
Yeah, it's not hard, so Austin doesn't have to worry about that.
Dustin with a sleeper. And the 6'6 youngster from Austin has that sleeper applied.
Yeah, but can he hook it good enough? I can't see from here. See the way Austin's got his hand up there? I don't think Rhodes could hook it good.
They got him in a bulldog, but it's Barry Windham.
Hey, it's Windham.
There's Barry Windham. Windham and Rhodes are fighting. The referee's called him for the disqualification. Austin.
Well, that's got to be a disqualification. That's no question about it.
Windham rams him right his lower back at the edge of the ring. Stunning Steve Austin holding Dustin Rhodes. Windham takes his boot off. He's hitting the kid right in the head.
He's smacking him with the heel of that hand.
He's trying to further injure that hand. It's chaotic here.
Yeah, he doesn't care about the fines, Jim. That's obvious. He wants to get rid of Dustin Rhodes, and he's doing it before your very eyes.
He's trying to destroy this kid's hand.
Okay, and now we're back with Barry Windham, a man who prior to that had already been fined $5,000 for your actions, and now you said you were on a quest to destroy Dustin Rhodes.
Schiavone, what do you think $5,000 means to me? At this point in time, it means nothing. Dustin Rhodes is what I want, but knowing the way that his family is, I doubt that he's got the guts to show up. Now, in this program today, we are going to have it out. So, Dustin Rhodes, if you've got the gumption, if you want to get this thing over with, step into the ring with me and show me what you've got. Because I've been around you for years, and I know exactly what you're made of, and I have my serious doubts about you right now.
All right, that from Barry Windham, and what a great main event it will be as we go back to the ring for our next match.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first at 231 pounds, from Marietta, Georgia, Marcus Alexander Bigwell! In the ring, his opponent weighs in at 237 pounds, from Washington, D.C., Tommy Angel.
Well, I have every confidence that Dustin Rhodes will be here on this broadcast, but be that as it may, this should be an outstandingly competitive matchup. Tommy Angel and Marcus Alexander Bagwell. It's Angel with the advantage here in the early going with a side headlock. Oh. And takes it into a takeover. Good move. Countered into the head scissors, but not for long. Bagwell, one of the most competitive young men in WCW. Win, lose, or draw, you always get 100% effort from this youngster from Marietta, Georgia.
You know, you can't take it away from him, Jim. He's been WCW year. He's even been in the ring against some big, tough names and held his own. Good physical conditioning. It's just the experience is what he needs.
Tommy Angel has some experience, an outstanding competitor, as we mentioned. Good drop kick into the arm drag as Marcus Alexander Bagwell takes down Tommy Angel. Special hello to all of our great friends in the Columbus, Ohio area. Big event in Columbus tonight as Bagwell drives a knee right into the bicep.
Yeah, he's working on that arm. And you know, again, here's, if you can imagine that the level of nerves, two men, nationwide television, going after that victory, trying to impress the promoters.
Oh! Nice hip lock takeover into the arm drag. Bagwell using his quickness quite nicely here in the early going.
Well, that's what it is. It's speed and science. The way he's got that weight pushing down on top of his shoulder.
Not a bad counter by Tommy Angel, but Bagwell shows great concentration to hold on to the arm. Well, that is his focus here.
Yeah, back to the arm. He's getting the basics down real good. He's getting the basics down good. He can hold his own against a guy like Angel, who's got a little more experience. That's all he can ask for.
And quite frankly, Angel has everything to gain here and nothing to lose. He's perhaps in this contest will go in as a slight underdog, but he's certainly not wrestling like an underdog here. Goal! Heard the impact of that crossbody. He reached back for the leg, couldn't find it, dropped toehold.
Yeah, he couldn't find the leg, but that was a nice counter move right here. Throwing Tommy Angel's momentum off. You're going for the arm drag. Angel thinking he's going to go for the arm drag. Boom, Bagwell's down at the ankle.
High impact. Clothesline. Angel now. Lateral press, and he did get the leg hook, but he couldn't hold Bagwell down for three. Scoops him up, and watch him slamming with a great deal of authority, driving the air out of Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Not giving any surcease here, as Gordon Soley would say. Knee to the midsection. Bagwell hooks it up, and he hit him with a suplex. That fisherman suplex hooks the leg, and it's over.
Here is your winner, Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
Very solid victory for Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Two Cold Scorpio is on deck, Larry, as we look one more time.
You know, it was a real good move here. He bent Angel over, took him over here, a lot of power, but watch him lock his hands together. Right there, he locked them. One, two, three. Good win for Bagwell.
Still to come, StarTech Cave Control Center and Two Cold Scorpio, and he is next.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first from Denver, Colorado, 239 pounds, Two Cold Scorpio!
Two Cold Scorpio! Get it on, Larry.
I don't know what he's doing now, but he just flew into
he's
the
dancing,
ring.
He's dancing, man. He's dancing.
Well, that's what you call it.
Well, great moves, and he really
Ladies
has.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Cheyenne, Wyoming, Mike Thor.
Really has this crowd captivated. The veteran from Cheyenne, Wyoming, Mike Thor, will try to slow down this offensive machine known as Tuco Scorpio. We talked to him last week. He's excited about entering Battle Bowl. Arm drag takedown by Thor. There's no guarantee that his name will be one of the 12 drawn on Monday, December 28th, because there's going to be, I heard, 40, 50 names in the pot, so to speak.
Whoa.
Great arm drag takeover.
Yeah, there's 40 names in the pot, but I tell you what, he's hoping his name's going to be drawn. That's one thing for sure. Just like 39 other guys. But I tell you, he has captivated the crowd. There's no question about the athletic ability of this man. And time will tell the story of Too Cold Scorpio.
Great move there, using the ropes for some leverage. Nice takedown, Larry.
Yeah, good takedown. He's even got that arm bar right. Look at the way his bicep is underneath the elbow of Thor. He wants to push out with that hand, pull up with that elbow.
Mike Thor back up to a vertical base. He's Irish whip right at us here. Look at the great agility this man. Drop kick, caught him right on the button. Whoa. And he went for it one more time, and Thor saw that one coming. He was able to avoid it, and he comes back with a knife-edge chop of his own. Thor going for the clothesline. He found nothing but air. It was where Scorpio was. Keep your eye on this young man. High risk. Oh, my gosh!
Superman is dead.
I mean, that was like suspended animation.
He flew.
He had some hang time. And I'd love to see that one again. What hang time? He puts his own body on the line here. Suplex outside, back in. Tuco Scorpio is red hot right now.
Well, I tell you, and Thor, he doesn't know where he is. He turned around and he just saw Superman flying at him.
He drove the elbow right into his chest and catches him with that side slam.
He's knocked the air out of Thor is what he did, and that was the final. Oh, man.
Here it comes. That's Too Cold. It's Too Cold.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Too Cold Scorpio.
Well, Larry, you described this one, I'm sure, as only you can. He's getting down in the ring.
Well, he may be getting down in the ring, but he sure got down on top of Thor. Right here, he flew. Talk about hang time. He finally came down on top of Thor, but he knocked the wind out of the man right here. 1.5. I don't know why they call him Too Cold, because the man is hot and not a Jim Ross.
Fans, I've been doing this a long time, and I have never seen anything like we've witnessed here on WCW Saturday Night. We're only a couple of weeks away now. Battle Bowl, and that ring has got to be on your mind.
Oh, yeah. Battle Bowl 1992. Ain't no better place to be than down here in WCW. I got one thing to say, like I said before. When I come down to the Battle Bowl, folks will know who Too Cold is.
Fans, you may want to get the size of that ring. Get it made for Tuco Scorpio. When we come back, it's the Starrcade Control Center. Who will wrestle Steamboat and Douglas at Starrcade? We'll tell you when we come back.
Introducing first from New York City at 290 pounds, heavy metal, Finn Hammer.
Hey, you come with me right here. I'm bringing a lot of bass and a lot of trouble, and I'm gonna pump up the volume, baby.
In the ring, his opponent weighs in at 228 pounds from Honolulu, Hawaii, Chris Sullivan.
And welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Heavy Metal Van Hammer turned on here. And if you just joined us, big news in the Starrcade Control Center. It'll be Barry Windham and Flying Brian Pillman to challenge Ricky Steamboat and Shane Douglas for the Unified World Tag Titles at Starrcade 92. And it's Heavy Metal Van Hammer who kicks it off with a surprise, Larry, a power wrestling move.
I tell you, he just threw Sullivan around like a piece of paper.
Hammer 6'5", maybe 6 feet six.
Yeah, tall guy. He's got a lot of leverage right here. That's about the only thing to do is yank his hair and get that leverage off you, and he's still hung on.
Hammer certainly, not only is his popularity growing, but his mat expertise is increasing as well. Sullivan got those forearms to the kidneys, but it's Hammer again coming right back to power and using that shoulder block to put Sullivan down.
Well, he definitely is catching on to the experience. You know, I had a wrestling coach that told me, you never know a move until you've done it 1,000 times, and that just takes time.
Hammer measuring Sullivan. Oh. That running knee lift caught Sullivan right in a solar plexus, and the impact drives him right outside. Heavy Metal Van Hammer firmly in control. You gotta wonder how he and Dangerous Dan Spivey will, what kind of teamwork they will have at Battle Bowl when they meet Hammer's good friend Johnny B. Badd and Cactus Jack.
Well, that is gonna be an interesting situation. Personally, I don't think Hammer and Spivey are gonna have any tag team, you know, coordination whatsoever.
Sullivan really fires up with those right hands after raking the eyes and has infuriated Hammer, it would seem, as he looks to the man from Hawaii down, backs him into the corner, comes to those kicks to the midsection, Irish whip. Coe caught that one and turned him inside out.
Yeah, he took the man right off his feet. Hammer is pumped.
Hammer's one of the young athletes that really feeds off the enthusiasm generated by the great fans of WCW. Now he's got the front face lock hooked. Here comes that Hammer Rock suplex. He muscles him up and takes him down. The leg is hooked and it's over.
Here is your winner, Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
Fans, we'll be going down the locker room momentarily. Teddy Long is scheduled to talk to Big Van Vader and Harley Race. But we'll take another look here, Larry.
Well, I tell you, Van Hammer just outsized the man, outpowered him. And right here, he hit him with a slingshot. Bam, pulled him right over, and he really hooked the leg good, brought the weight up. Good victory for Van Hammer.
Teddy Long is standing by. Could he be standing next to the next King of Cable? Harley Race thinks so.
Well, Harley Race, we know one thing, that your man is one victory away from becoming the King of Cable winner, but you have to be a little overconfident, Harley, to say that your man is gonna go into Starrcade 92, take Sting out, and become the winner of the King of Cable competition.
Well, you can't say that we're overconfident. You saw the Stinger come out with a 2x4 from behind, and it couldn't take this man out. Now, ask him what's gonna happen.
Well, Cable, Starrcade 92, brother. No fear. Bring more than your 2x4. Bring it all, Sting!
I guess what you heard, you hear the rumor.
Yeah.
Dustin Rhodes isn't gonna be here. I guess he had a personal problem at home. He's not gonna be here at all. Dustin, where are you, Pally?
Where you at, boy? Where you at?
Welcome back, everyone. Don't forget to call the Wrestling Hotline. Some hot news until midnight tonight. Hope you'll be with us tomorrow night on AM 750 WSB at 9 for our radio program. But Larry, Ravishing Rick Rude is sitting right where he wants to be. The number one contender for the world title. He's got Ron Simmons in 2 weeks.
And I tell you, that's right up Rick Rude's alley, because he's an egotistical maniac with the ability to beat Ron Simmons.
And he is the subject of this week's Up Close.
Our first chance to sit down and talk with the man who is the longest reigning U.S. heavyweight champion in WCW history, Ravishing Rick Rude, along with the first lady of WCW, Medusa. 1 week ago in a tag team match, scored what many people consider a very controversial win over world heavyweight champion Ron Simmons.
Do you consider it a controversial win, Shivani?
Well, in many respects, yes, I do.
That's because you are just like all the low-life fans out there. Everything Ravishing Rick Rude does is controversial. But the bottom line is, I beat Ron Simmons with the Rude Awakening, 1, 2, 3, right in the middle of the ring. Better a controversial victory than a clean-cut loss.
Okay, fair enough. So now, you and Ron Simmons head up Starrcade 92, Monday, December 28th, for the World Heavyweight title. You are the number one contender, being U.S. Heavyweight Champion.
That's right, Shivani. And I have been the number one contender for over 365 miserable mornings. Four men have come to power in the WCW. Four men have sat on a throne. Four men have won the title, and four men have lost the title, while Ravishing Rick Rude has sat idle as the number one contender. Ron Simmons, his name was drawn out of a hat.
It certainly was in Baltimore back on August 2nd. As you approach the match with Ron Simmons, World Heavyweight Champion, you have to realize here's a guy, maybe the greatest physical specimen in WCW. How do you attack an athlete like Ron Simmons? In other words, what's your strategy going into Starrcade?
That would have been a tough question a week ago, Shivani, because when you analyze Ron Simmons, you have to look at his past opponents and the strategies that he has taken to become world champion. You look at the man, and seemingly, he has no physical weaknesses.
That's right.
Seemingly. But you see, that's where the homework comes in handy. Ducey ran into a doctor friend of Ron Simmons. She gave a favor, she got a favor. Show us what you got, Deuce.
What is this?
I have to be honest. Just watch it.
What is this?
You'll love it.
What this is, Shivani, it's an x-ray of a badly damaged shoulder that Ron Simmons has been trying to hide from the public. Well, it's not secret anymore, Simmons. I know your weakness. I know your strength. And I know that Starrcade 92, I will become the next WCW world champion by any means necessary. And one more thought. There's a man waiting in the wings who says I owe him a favor. Big Van Vader. You're right, Vader. You did me a favor. I owe you a favor. I'll give you a shot at the title, but it's not going to be my United States title. It'll be the world title.
That's it from Ravishing Rick Rude on WCW Up Close.
WCW Saturday Night, Jim Ross and Larry Zbyszko back with you. Recently, Eric Watts had the opportunity to take on the U.S. champion, Ravishing Rick Rude. It was not a successful outing for Eric as far as wins and losses were concerned, but I know he learned a great deal in that match.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's besides the point. You get in the ring with a man like Rude, you're going to get a real quick education. I'm sure Eric Watts, maybe down the road after, you know, some time, will be a different situation.
Well, I think you're exactly right about that, and our colleague Tony Schiavone caught up with Eric Watts a little bit earlier this week, and here was their conversation.
Okay, we're joined by one of the young lions in World Championship Wrestling, Eric Watts, tremendous athlete. Eric, I want to talk to you about a match. A challenge was made by U.S. Heavyweight Champion Ravishing Rick Rude, a challenge you accepted. What were you thinking?
I thought it was a challenge just like any other challenge. I was going to face it head on, Rick Rude or anybody else. On this one, I was jumping from the pan into the fire, but I was ready.
Well, let's take a look at some of the footage.
Right there, I went in a little bit nervous. I went in a little bit tentative. When you go in against someone like Rick Rude, you don't want to be nervous or tentative. And he took advantage of that. He probably saw it in my eyes going out into the ring.
Yeah, he's attacking, apparently, attacking every part of the body right here.
Right there, from the arm to the leg. Earlier, he was on the head. And every one of those blows, you could feel from there back to Bixby.
Pound on the back. I mean, this is the first part of the match, and he is, like you said, really on it.
Yeah, I believe he was knocking the nervousness right out of me. I was right here, he hit me in the gut. I'm trying to find myself. I'm trying to find exactly where I'm at.
Okay, later in the match now, you were firing right back on him.
Man, I was firing. I'd got the nervousness out of me. I felt good right here. Gave him a knee back to the gut like he'd given me earlier. Knocked the breath out of him. Taking his head to it now.
And there, from there, Eric, you still didn't stop right into him.
No, I'm feeling good. I'm feeling real good, and I'm giving him everything I've got. You can see those elbows right to the head. I missed him. He missed me. Set it to his gut again.
Here's where you hooked him, and you almost had him.
Man, I thought I was hooked in tight. One, two, and he kicks out. I'm feeling good about myself, rush in. Boom, rookie mistake, call it what you want right there. 1, 2, 3. Rick Rude wins the battle. With Rick Rude, the war's just begun. As you can tell, 3 times, Tony, I came back.
Right after the match.
This is the first one. I have to turn him around, I have to give him a gut punch and then bring his chin down. But he fights back. You know, there he is, the veteran. He's giving me a few shots. But what amazes me is how he's always walking away from me. Here's the second time you're walking away. I've got to bring you back into the ring. I've got to give you a little bit of my own. Then yeah, he turns me over, he gives me some. But why would you walk away? Why do you think I'm gonna quit? I do not quit, I never quit, I never give up. And on the third occasion here, I've got to stop you again, get your attention, you're holding your belt. I mean, he's making a little mistake on his own because why in his mind would he think that I'm gonna give up?
Why would he turn his, oh, wow.
Yeah, he gave me a shot, but this is the shot that he needs to remember. He needs to remember this shot for always. Always and forever, I'm gonna stand. I'm not gonna quit. He can see in my face and in my eyes, I'm not gonna stop, I'm not gonna quit. Because he did not break my bones. He did not break my will. He did not break the desire to win. Rick Rude, we're gonna meet again. We're gonna meet again. Another town, another place, different fans, different people. But when you meet Eric Watts, I'm gonna be standing, and I'm gonna be standing a lot taller.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first from Bixby, Oklahoma, weighing in at 259 pounds, Eric Watts. In the ring, his opponent weighs in at 320 pounds from Boise, Idaho, Fred Avery.
Big Fred Avery, well over 300 pounds to take on Eric Watts. And I think the interesting thing about that, Larry, what we just saw is that Eric fully realizes he's a better wrestler for having wrestled a man like Ravishing Rick Rude.
Well, that's the only way you're gonna have to take that situation. The better caliber you wrestle, the more you're gonna learn. It's a fact of life.
Big Fred Avery's gonna be quite a physical challenge for Eric. I'm sure he outweighs Eric up well over 100 pounds. Arm drag takeover. Watts has gotta be quick here, that's exactly what we're seeing. He's gonna use that leverage, good drop kick, and takes the big man, Big Fred, outside.
Boy, Fearless Fred went flying, and I tell you, there's a lot of them. Watts caught him off guard, hit him with some good combinations. I think Fred is changing his strategy.
You know, one thing about it, Eric has learned the STF, and that is certainly an equalizer, no matter the size of your opponent.
No, if you can hook that hold on somebody, it's a very devastating dual combination submission.
He's trying to take him outside here, Larry. He's got that front face lock, trying to take the kid outside. Eric's trying to block it, and he got the big man up and over.
That's a lot of weight.
That's a load. Drives that fist right down into his face. Out of foot, right to the midsection. And he brings him out of the corner.
Oh!
Drops the elbow. Reaches back for the lateral press. Got two out of it with the big man. Able to get the shoulders up. No matter the skill level of a big, strong athlete, when you meet a man that outweighs you 100 pounds, it's got to alter your strategy and your technique somewhat, I would think.
Oh, yeah, no, there's no doubt about it. You definitely want to go after him in a different way. Work those extremities. Work the arm like Eric is here to hammerlock. Keep him on the mat. You don't want to do things like, you know, single leg takedowns. You don't want to go underneath his weight.
Avery able to get a foot in the ropes, and we got a clean sportsmanlike break on this occasion. Eric back quickly to gain the advantage. Didn't let Avery get back up to his feet, but he doesn't have to.
Hey, he broke clean. So how much of a break do you want to give the guy?
Avery now, that big forearm and then the shoulder into the corner. Irish whip.
Oh, he walked into that elbow.
Watts caught him, and Larry, here it comes.
If he can turn him over. Oh!
Oh, my.
Man, that's a knee smasher.
Right there, he's got him, and Avery gives it up. It's over.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Eric Watts.
All right, well, Larry Zbyszko is going to talk to Eric Watts in a few moments. And fans, you just saw perhaps the most devastating submission move in the entire sport, the STF. Step over toe, look at him drive it down. Eric's right leg is the base point, the front face lock, but he's putting a tremendous torque on the knee, on the ligaments, stretching them. Avery gives it up, and Eric Watts is standing by with Larry, the Cruncher, Zbyszko.
You know, let me say something, Eric, about the STF. Very, very deadly combination, submission hold, step over toe hold, reverse cross face. You've mastered it well. And for a young man, you need it because you have been under a baptism of fire in WCW with what I think is an unfair bounty.
Thank you, Mr. Zbyszko. I'm happy with how I'm coming along. But let's talk about something real, the Battle Bowl. I want that ring. Just like when we played college, we had the Fiesta Bowl championship. Now it's the Battle Bowl. I can hardly wait till we get it on. Starrcade, it's coming up, and I get to be against all those guys I used to look for.
Well, wait a minute. I'm out here conducting an interview. I want nothing.
Wait a minute, Eric Watts. Boy, I got something of a little interest for you. See, me and Shanghai, we just came into a lot of money. And you know what kind of money that is, boy? That's bounty money. And I've seen a lot of people trying to get that bounty on you, brother. And let me tell you something. When Texans take a bounty, it gets took, brother. That's all I got to say.
Well, let me tell you what, Mr. Zbyszko. First, you better check what money that bank's coming from, because I don't think the check's any good. Second of all, you got to be a man to collect a bounty. But most of all, that Texan in Shang Lo better make sure they're not on the wrong side of the Red River.
Well, good luck to you. We'll be right back after this.
Thanks for staying with us, everyone, here on TBS. Don't forget, fans, if you want to see Starrcade live in the Omni on Monday, December the 28th, tickets are available at all area Ticketmaster locations throughout the Southeast, and we'll have a very special phone number for you right here next week if you'd like to charge by phone. If you can't be with us in Atlanta, you can certainly call your cable company and watch it on pay-per-view. Now, coming up in a few moments, very special tag team matchup, the Unified Champions in a challenge match against Beautiful Bobby and Stunning Steve Austin. But, Larry, it was originally scheduled to be Arn Anderson and Beautiful Bobby.
Yes, it was. You know, and Eric Watts, with that perfected STF that he learned, basically put Arn out of commission. It was the first time in my career that I've heard Arn Anderson submit.
Arn Anderson injured, unable to compete in this contest thanks to the STF. But this should be an awesome tag team event, one of our feature attractions here on WCW Saturday Night. Let's go back up to Tony Gillum.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first main event of WCW Saturday Night is set for one fall. It is a special tag team event. Michael P.S. Hayes leads team number one to the ring, weighing at a combined weight of 491 pounds, Beautiful Bobby and Stunning Steve Austin.
Michael P.S. Hayes, the strategist, leading Stunning Steve Austin and Beautiful Bobby to the ring. This is a very formidable combination. This is a non-title event, a special challenge matchup. The Unified Champions, Steamboat and Douglas, at Starrcade. Their opponents, in case you just joined us, Barry Windham and Fly-In Brian Pillman. Back up to Tony Gillum.
Ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, they are the Unified World Tag Team Champions. They weigh at a combined weight of 481 pounds, Shane Douglas and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Douglas and Steamboat, the Unified World Tag Team Champions. We saw them here last week. They were very, very successful. They looked very proficient in their tag team skills. But this team, on this day, much more proficient than their opponents last week. This is going to be an outstanding contest.
Yeah, and it's going to be a lot tougher for Steamboat and Douglas than last week, because right here, Austin and Eaton have been together a lot longer, have been training together, believe me, I know. And they are, you know, Bobby Eaton right there, textbook wrestler. And they've got Michael Hayes in the corner. He's laying out the strategy right there. You can see him talking. Believe me, they've got their game plan down.
Fans, before the bell sounds, don't forget to join us tomorrow on the main event. 1989, that championship year continues for you. Mike Atkins calls for the bell, and we have it. It will be Shane Douglas and beautiful Bobby Eaton kicking it off here. Eaton, a tremendous tag team wrestler, forces Shane Douglas back into the corner. And Douglas reverses the pressure, and we have a clean break. Eaton had so much success with the vaunted Midnight Express back in the 80s. Side headlock as Douglas has control. Waistlock by beautiful Bobby.
You know, I noticed in these tag matches, Steamboat usually lets Shane start. Oh!
Good move there by beautiful Bobby. Nice takedown. He cradled a leg and got Douglas on his shoulders. And he takes him there one more time and another near fall.
You see Douglas shaking his head like he's almost feels silly he got caught in that move. But I was saying Steamboat likes to let Shane Douglas start, and I think that's a smart strategy because Steamboat, you know, wants to keep himself ready. He wants to keep himself fresh. He's the experienced man in there.
Knee to the midsection by beautiful Bobby Eaton. Fans, we understand that Barry Windham has got one thing right. Dustin Rhodes is not here right now. We don't know exactly the story behind that. Tag was made. We'll keep you informed. That match is still scheduled. Windham and Rhodes in the program. Good double team here.
It's a double team, and Steamboat's the legal man. Oh!
Austin in, but he's down, and he's outside. Dropped toe by Steamboat on beautiful Bobby.
You know, beautiful Bobby, he doesn't know what's going on in there right now. He didn't see the tag between Douglas and Steamboat. The next thing Eaton knows, he's flat in his face.
Larry, the strategy is very key on the referee's count as Eaton got the knee to the midsection, makes a tag. Steamboat with an arm drag takeover. You can stay in the ring as long as the referee doesn't reach his five count as Steamboat makes a tag to Shane Douglas.
You've got a five count, take it.
Take advantage of the count. Is exactly what they did. And boy, look at these quick tags right in their corner. World Tag Team Champions in and out, keeping stunning Steve Austin off balance.
Well, I tell you something right now, just by watching these men, I bet my poke on it, they have been training and training super hard. You talk about, you know, Pillman and Windham coming up, that's gonna be a brutal match if it gets that far, because they gotta get right through here, Austin and Bobby Eaton. And I know Michael Hayes got something up his sleeve, brother.
Well, Steamboat's been to the big dance before, but this will be Douglas' first time at a pay-per-view and a championship match as the Unified World Tag Champions. Steamboat's been there before.
Oh.
Good move there by Douglas. He was able to just outmaneuver stunning Steve Austin. Got him that scoop slam. Goes to the lateral press, and he got two out of it. Didn't think he'd get two.
Really, Austin was going for a move right there, but Douglas outslicked him.
Austin seemed a little disoriented there momentarily. Makes the tag. Here comes beautiful Bobby in, and Douglas shows some good ring savvy. Fought his way out of the corner, and then takes beautiful Bobby to Douglas' half of the ring.
Yes, that was very good, and that's the stuff that comes with experience. As soon as he got in that corner, he said the heck with the moves. Fists were flying, and he was out with Eaton. Very good. He's from Pittsburgh, you know.
I know that, yes. So is my good friend Bill Frelick of the Atlanta Falcons. A lot of great athletes in Pittsburgh.
I'm from Pittsburgh,
oh, yeah.
Ross.
Right, I forgot. Tag made. Here comes stunning Steve Austin. He is from Hollywood, and he buried that right hand deep in the abdomen of Shane Douglas. And Douglas now, you can see Douglas slowing down his momentum as he's being punished by Austin, who's controlling the pace.
Yeah, well, Austin came from Hollywood, and Shane Douglas is seeing stars.
Lateral press up the leg. Douglas, double leg pickup. He's going right for the fist.
He's fighting back, but he's got to tag Steamboat. Get out of there, that's it.
That's exactly what he did. The emotional young Shane Douglas tags in the steady leader of the team, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Again, double team offense, all within the five count of the rules. Wide base by Steamboat, arm barred, great position.
Yeah, he's got his body in the right place. Look at how he arches up, really yanking out the shoulder of stunning Steve Austin.
Great technique exhibited by Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Won tag team titles with Paul Jones and Jay Youngblood and Dustin Rhodes. He's been the world's heavyweight champion. This man has so many honors. And he is just, it seems like he just gets better each and every year. He keeps himself in magnificent condition, and he is wrenching back. He's looking for a submission here.
He could get one with this. Steamboat, world-class athlete. I think the only trouble with him is he's just not mean enough.
Well, he's showing some, always is tenacious, but you know, you may be right. He may not have that mean streak.
Killer
so to speak.
Instinct. I mean, really, a killer instinct is what you need. And I think if Steamboat had more of a killer instinct, he'd alleviate a lot of
good
less
move.
Beatings himself. Look at the way he's starting. That's a beautiful hold. The pressure he's putting on that hammerlock by being inverted like this is tremendous pain on Steve Austin. Look at the way he's got that leverage. His whole body is torn.
He could have torn the elbow right there if he could have maintained control. He just knocked beautiful Bobby right off the apron.
You know, the only thing that Austin could do to stop that is basically hold his own arm against the small of his back. Lock his own arm in.
Douglas back in after the tag with Ricky Steamboat. And Austin has him. Austin caught him for that side slam. And that was a big offensive move for the Austin-Eaton combination.
Oh, man, he spelled him right in the nose.
Tag made. Beautiful Bobby now. Trying to maintain control, but he couldn't get the elbow. Drop toho by Douglas. Douglas floats up to the head, grabs the arm into the arm bar, and backs near his corner where he makes the tag. And Steamboat comes in right off the top rope, using that for some additional leverage. Another shoulder block by the Dragon. Great move. And beautiful Bobby tried to take him over. Austin trying to get in the situation, got nailed. Steamboat he's like a cat. Walked right up the ropes like it was a ladder, and Austin interrupted the count. Steamboat may have had beautiful Bobby that time, but Eaton makes the tag to Austin.
Well, I tell you.
Great tag team matchup here.
Yeah, it's a good tag team matchup, but they got Steamboat in trouble, and I know how Austin and Eaton thinks, especially with Hayes out there. Look at him working on it. He's going to stay on Steamboat now.
Snapmares him over. And he drives the knee right into the chest and the face. And you can hear the pain. Steamboat writhing in pain as Austin drives a knee into the lower back and the kidneys. And beautiful Bobby with that tremendous right hand, and it did find its mark. And Steamboat tops back.
You know, Steamboat had his ribs broke some months ago, and they're still on that area. Small the back, the rib area. They're not cutting him no slack.
Combination move here by beautiful Bobby trying to execute the body scissors, and he's got the arm hook, Larry.
Yeah, he's got the arm bar. He's got him body scissored. Again, he's working on the ribs.
Fans, if you just joined us, don't forget, still to come, it is scheduled to be Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham, one-on-one. We will have to tell you also that Rhodes is not in the arena as of yet. Scheduled, obviously, to be here. He is not here now.
You know, it could be Dustin Rhodes doing a smart thing. If he's not 100%, why show up and get in the ring with a seasoned vet like Barry Windham? I think he just left.
Steamboat fighting back, but look at Eaton. He knew he was getting in trouble, made the tag. Austin caught him. Austin catches Steamboat, and you can see the dazed look on Steamboat's face. He was nailed with that clothesline. The legs hooked, and are half away from that upset victory in this special challenge match.
I tell you what you're seeing now
he's fighting for the tag. Fighting for the tag. That's where he's got to go.
The referee is right there. The referee is right there.
They're close. Inches away from making the exchange. Austin trying to grab the tights has done so. Beautiful Bobby distract the referee. And just how many times have you seen that? That was a big move by beautiful Bobby. He comes off the top. Double sledge right on the head.
So that's the inexperience of Douglas. He should have known that the referee would have to push him out.
Referee did not see the tag from Eaton and Austin either. Making Austin come back in.
Now the teamwork of Austin and Eaton is going to start shining through.
You never know what's going to happen if you have multiple athletes out here and only one referee. Look at Steamboat fight with all he's got. It doesn't matter if it's championship matchup or non-title. He's going to give you all he's got every time out. And what a counter by Austin. Steamboat trying to go with the guillotine. He's got the leg hook and another near fall. Austin turning it up here offensively on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. But Steamboat fights back. He's holding on with all he's got.
And I tell you, he's got to hold on because they've got to. Oh! Oh, man!
Steamboat used the DDT. That's the first time I've seen Steamboat use the DDT.
You know, that was an instinctual reflex on the part of Steamboat. That's what makes this man a world-class athlete. Austin bent over and Steamboat just slipped it to him.
Steamboat dazed. Austin tags in. He
got it!
He got the tag. Shane Douglas is in, and he is cooking. Beautiful Bobby, the legal man. Douglas scoops up Austin.
Well, the referee's pushing up. Now he's got them both in there now.
Referee's got to get Austin out of there, but here comes Steamboat again.
He's got to get Austin and Steamboat out. Shane Douglas, Beautiful Bobby, they're the legal men in the ring.
Referee's having trouble maintaining control here. My gosh, they're colliding like cars on I-85 on Friday afternoon. Austin scoops up Douglas. Got him with that slam.
Here comes the Alabama Jam. It's over.
Beautiful. Bobby caught him with the Alabama Jam. That should be all of us. Steamboat stopped the count. Steamboat caught him with that double axe handle.
Well, what a move by Steamboat. Just backflipped over Steve Austin. Made the save. There they go.
Douglas. Oh, Douglas caught him in the belly to belly. Douglas caught him in the belly to belly.
He got him.
Here is your unified world tag team champions, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Shane Douglas.
What a victory for the unified world tag team champions, Larry. And we'll look one more time.
I tell you, a sweet victory it was right here. Belly to belly, perfect timing on the part of Shane Douglas. Hooked the leg. One, two, three, Jim, they got him.
Fans, we'll be back. Will Dustin Rhodes be here? That's the question we'll attempt to answer when we come back from this time out.
Anticipated is what happens always with the Rhodes. They never show when the heat's on. I'll tell you what, Dustin Rhodes, for some reason or another, has decided to be a no-show and is not here tonight. So now here I am, face alone. I guess I'm gonna have to take it. Oh, here's one of his pals. Oh,
yes. Don't you dare talk about my friend like that. That's right. You had everything to do with it. That's right. You had everything to do with it.
Come on.
Ricky Steamboat. Well, I don't know if there's a challenge been made or not. Wyndham's got a chair.
Well, Steamboat's got a chair.
But there's Dustin Rhodes. There's Dustin Rhodes. He's right behind Wyndham.
Oh!
Rhodes and Wyndham.
Here's him take Wyndham's head off.
They're hugging it up here. What a fist fight. This is a fist fight.
Revenge
here. That's what he's after.